Welcome to Shanmugamayas Academy. Today we are going to see the Hindu newspaper analysis of 23rd November 2021 and some of the important news we are going to see here of the today's newspaper. That is, firstly, we are going to see we care more for a policy on MSP than PM's apology. It was told by the former union leader Rakesh Tikayat, and the brief background of this, we all know that the Guru Purab Day, that is Guru Nanak Jayanti, on that day, the Prime Minister has announced the government is going to repeal the three laws for which the farmers are protesting from more than a year in the Sanghu border in the Delhi region. We all know that. And the background is also, we know that they don't want their fate to be in the hands of the private players. They wanted to continue the system which is following from more than decades, and they wanted to sell their produce only in the wholesale markets and the mandis, and which was under the influence of the minimum support prices. They wanted this procedure to be followed. They don't want those laws which were newly given by the government. And thankfully, Prime Minister has told that the government is going to repeal those three laws. And in this, the Bharatiya Kisan Union spokesperson Rakesh Tikayat has told that on Sunday, apart from, because Prime Minister has told that they are going to repeal the laws, but they want a proof. They want is to be written the form of a gazette, and the law is guaranteed the minimum support price they wanted. Apart from that, the issues that needed to be resolved, that is the most important among them, being a law for guaranteed minimum support price. And other thing, he don't wanted to form a committee, because he said that the report submitted in 2011 by a group of chief ministers led by Mr. Modi, who was ruling Gujarat that time, then the Prime Minister Manmohan Singh had recommended a law for an MSP. The report was still lying on the PMO's office. So he said that they don't want a committee to be formed. He want the instant solution. Till that time, this protest is said to be going through, and the repealing of the laws in the winter session to be written on the gazette, and otherwise they won't be taking their protest out. And another thing is, here is, they want a guaranteed minimum support price, and which some of the issues they have, they needed that to be resolved along with the repealing of this laws. So this is the first issue. So we care more for the policy on MSP than PM's apology and Rakesh Tikayat. And this news is following from so many days. And we'll go into the next issue, the next news. The Supreme Court to hear the Mullai Periyar Dam case on December 10th. We all know this issue. This was happening. We are reading this news from so many days and so many years. And we know this. The Supreme Court has told yesterday that they are going to hear the Mullai Periyar Dam case. What in that? Especially, the Supreme Court are agreed and to hear comprehensively the questions on the safety of the dam and maintenance of the 126-year-old Mullai Periyar Dam. Because the Kerala government is saying that the dam is not safer to the people who are living around the region. But this issue is Supreme Court is going to hear on December 10th. And the bench has said that, and the bench is led by Justice A.M. Khanwilkar, fixed a hearing the case for the directions immediately after the conclusion of two ongoing cases. And he said that the bench said the registry would put up the Mullai Periyar case even earlier than December 10 if two part heard matters included sooner than the expected. And the Justice Khanwilkar also said that diverse petitions filed on the various aspects of safety, maintenance of the dam, and security of the people living near. And the Tamil Nadu government is arguing that so far stood firm by its position in the court that the dam is hydrologically, structurally and seismically safe. A social media campaign was on in Kerala against the dam, and it was The protest, it was the thing always the Tamil Nadu government was saying. They were saying the dam is hydrologically and the structurally and seismically safe, but the Kerala government is in the opposite direction. They are saying this dam is not safer for the people who are living around the region. So further, Supreme Court is going to hear the case, the Mullay Periyar dam case, on December 10th. So this is the second news, and the third one, fastly will move. And we all know that the AP has formed a law to form three capitals, but here they are also told today that the AP decentralization and inclusive development all regions act aimed at settling up three capitals, and the Capital Region Development Authority Repeal Act of 2020. So the Andhra Pradesh government has Monday passed a bill to repeal AP Decentralization and Inclusive Development of All Regions Act. And in this, the government plans to bring more comprehensive law that dispels the wrong notions of the land givers, because so many farmers in the Amaravati region are protesting against this, and they wanted to bring a more comprehensive law to dispel the wrong notions of the land givers, because the farmers who are the land givers in the Amaravati region, so they wanted the law to be more comprehensive, and they wanted to clarify their position on the legalities raised by the petitioners in the High Court. Because so many petitions has been raised in the High Court, so they wanted to clarify the positions and the legalities. So they wanted to repeal the laws of the three capital formations in the Andhra Pradesh. The activist residents to initiate process to restore waterways. And we all know that the waterman of India, and his name is Rajendra Singh. And on Monday in city, the Chennai city, he launched an initiative for the mobilization of resident associations in the city to restore waterways for management of floods and drought. So we all know that Chennai, from last 2 weeks we are seeing floods and everything was going on. So he launched an initiative for mobilization of the residents association there. The initiative is a part of Tamil Nadu River Retrieval Movement. So this is important and coordinated with the Indian Peninsular River Basins Council. So this was coordinated with the Indian Peninsular River Basins Council. And the main thing he was saying, and they were saying, that the option, the various options to save waterways and promote policy measures. Because the argument here is the encroachments on water bodies is the biggest challenge in the city. Because the encroachment is happening for the most water bodies which are government property, the record is not good, because the land value where the water bodies are there is very high, and the people build houses in those water bodies in the form of encroachment. The encroachment is really bringing disaster. This is what told by the waterman of India, Rajendra Singh. And he also told that he is not saying that we are destroying these buildings constructed in water bodies in urban areas, but rather prevent further encroachments in areas with rapid urbanization. So there is also a slit in these water bodies. He is saying to prevent further encroachments in those areas, which, because we all know that we are going towards the rapid urbanization process. This was told by Mr. Rajendra Singh. Is the waterman of India. This is an important news for the Tamil Nadu River Retrieval Movement. The movement, this was initiative of the mobilization of resident associations. Next news, the Bhandari takes charge as acting Chief Justice of High Court. We all know that Madras High Court Chief Justice has been transferred to the Meghalaya High Court, and Article 222 says that the Chief Justice of India can be transferred from one High Court to the another High Court. That is, Chief Justice of High Court can be transferred from one High Court to the another High Court, and Chief Justice of India is the chief determiner of this. This is Article 222, and here Bhandari takes charge as the acting Chief Justice of High Court, and this High Court. So, Chief Justice is appointed by the collegium. We all know that the Chief Justice of India and the other four senior most judges will be in this collegium process. And another thing here is the High Court's Advocate General and office bearers of the Bar Councils of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry and various Bar Association has welcomed the additional Chief Justice. So here they said that it will not say much today, but we'll see it in the action. He told the gathering expressing happiness over the having got an opportunity to preside over the prestigious Madras High Court. And other thing, Mr. Bhandari has enrolled as a lawyer in 1983 itself, and he was worked as a he's was elevated from the bar to the bench of the Rajasthan High Court on July 5th, 2007, and he was transferred to the Allahabad High Court. He also worked in the railways of Rajasthan Road Transport Corporation. He worked in the Standing Council for the Railways and Rajasthan Road Transport Corporation, Nuclear Power Corporation, State Election Commission, and Rajasthan University, among others. And during his stint, Allahabad High Court has served as the Acting Chief Justice between June 26 to June 2021 to October 2021. So according to the sources, he was saying that Justice Bhandari will be considered for the post of Chief Justice of the Madras High Court after December 23. So this is one of the news. And other news, Pakistan to allow wheat transit to Afghanistan. Because 1 month earlier, India offered humanitarian assistance to Afghanistan, but Pakistan Prime Minister said his government would allow the aid to transit over the land route through Pakistan. India had protested against the delay in Pakistan's permission for the aid to be facilitated recently, which was held in the 8-nation regional security dialogue on Afghanistan in New Delhi, which has ended with a declaration that called for assistance to be unimpeded. And Prime Minister also announced a decision that to allow 50,000 MT of the wheat India has offered to provide Afghanistan in humanitarian assistance. And along with that, he added he also decided to facilitate the return of Afghan patients who had gone to India for medical treatment and stuck here. And because why this was there, because the offer of wheat and other medical supplies was made formally to the Taliban regime by the Ministry of External Affairs delegation that attended the Moscow Format Conference in Russia. So here our Ministry of External Affairs has offered wheat and other medical supplies was made formally to the Taliban regime, which was held the delegation that attended the Moscow Format Conference in Russia. And President give away the gallantry awards. We all know that Abhinandan Vartaman, who held captivity for 3 days, we all know that, and he downed a Pakistani fighter jet in 2019 and was awarded Veer Chakra. He was awarded Veer Chakra. This is the third highest wartime gallantry award. Please note it down. And it was given by President of India. And what happened that time, that is the citation, that is the fourth generation F-16 and JF-17 were detected heading towards the line of control. And this was the Pakistani Air Force fighter aircraft consisting of advanced fourth generation F-16 and JF-17 are detected heading towards the line of control. And what happened that time, the citation pointed out that the wing commander, that time he was the wing commander, Vartaman, displaying exceptional air combat and knowledge of enemy's tactics. And he scanned the low latitude airspace with his airborne intercept radar and picked up an enemy aircraft that was flying low to ambush the Indian fighter interceptor aircraft. So he alerted the information to the other pilots about the surprise threat there, and then consolidated the riposte against the hostile aircraft that was attempting to drop weapons on the Indian Army positions. So all the enemy aircraft thereafter turned back because of this advanced information, turned back, including the rear Echelon aircraft that were yet to launch their air to the ground. So because now the Abhinav Vartman has been retreating with the enemy fighter bomber aircraft and he attacked them and he ensured aerial combat. He shot down an F-16 aircraft with his onboard missile that time. So for this courageous work, Abhinav Vartman has been awarded with Veer Chakra, which is the third highest wartime gallantry award, which was given by President of India. And authoritarianism is on the rise, says report. So democratic decline in India is worrying. And it was the report which was released by the International Institute for Democracy and Electoral Assistance on Monday. The number of countries moving towards authoritarianism in 2020 was higher than of the countries going in the other direction towards the democracy. And this was the report released by the International Institute for Democracy and Electoral Assistance, and it was said on Monday. And we can take the great examples, because the Afghanistan regime and the Myanmar regime, which is in the control of army, and Afghanistan regime, which is in the control of the Taliban, which are democracies earlier. So with these kind of examples, this report has also told that this highlighted the case of Brazil and India, the some of the most worrying examples, that backsliding. However, India remained in the category of a mid-level performing democracy, as it has since 2000 report. The United States and other three members of the European Union, that is Hungary, Poland and Slovenia, have also seen concerning democratic declines. So this is the report which is given by the International Institute for Democracy and Electoral Assistance. So they told that the countries are moving towards authoritarianism in 2020 was higher than that of countries going in the other direction, that is towards the democracy. So here's some of the important news of the Hindu news analysis up to 23rd November 2021. Please, if you have any queries, just tell us in the comment section. And thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.